In this video, I'm going to show you how you can repeat a form field in the header of your document. As you know, form fields actually can't be used in headers and footers where you're trying to repeat that header if you're trying to use a ref field. However, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use a style ref so that if you do have a header and you want to repeat a form field that a user fills in and have whatever they fill in show up in that header, I'm going to show you a way to do that in this video today. If you want to learn how to create fillable forms, be sure and check out the playlist on my channel. I have several videos that show you how to create fillable forms and do lots of neat things with your forms. In this video, we're going to use a time off request template. I also have some templates available for purchase. If you're interested, I'll include a link in the description below the video. Thanks for supporting my channel. All right, what we're going to do is create a header on this document. So we're going to go up to Insert, and we're going to insert a header. And so this will work with headers or footers. If you have a footer that you want to create and you want to have a form field repeat in that header or footer, we're just going to do a header here. And let's just say time off request form four, and then we want to have the employee's name pop up there in the header as an example. All right, let's close out of our header for now, because the first thing we need to do is we actually need to create a new character style, because instead of using a ref, which doesn't actually work in a header, we're going to use something called a style ref. So we're going to come down here to the employee name form field, and I can select it and come up here on my developer tab and click on properties, or I can double click the form field to open up the properties. And notice that we have bookmarked this form field. I've already labeled it EE name. So this is the bookmark for this particular form field. And so I'm going to click on OK. Now the next thing I want to do is create a new character style for this form field. So I have the form field selected. I'm going to come up to the Home tab, and over here where you have styles, you'll see this little button where you can expand the style menu. Click on that little icon there in the corner, and then you'll have the styles menu pop up over here, and then go ahead and click on this little plus icon where it says new style. We're going to create a new style. We're going to name it the same name that we have that form field bookmarked. So we're going to call it EE name and click OK. All right, so now we have this employee name selected as a style for this form field. And so now what we're going to do is close out of the styles here. And now we're going to come back up to our header. We're going to click on Insert, Header, Edit Header. And we're going to include a style ref. And one way we can do that is come up to Insert, Quick Parts, Field, scroll down till you see Style Ref. We're going to click on Field Codes, and here within the quotes is where we're going to type in the name of that style that we did, which is a bookmark, which is EE name. And we're going to click OK. All right, so we've inserted that. You can't see it. If you want to be able to see your field codes, all you have to do is hit Alt F9 or Alt Function F9 depending on your keyboard, and that will show you, it will make the reference code in form fields reference behind the scenes, the information pop up for you. So you'll see style ref, EE name, and merge formats automatically applied to that for formatting. So all we have to do to hide that back again is simply hit Alt F9 again to hide it, and we'll just hit Alt Function F9. And so then we can come back up to our header and footer ribbon tab up here and close it out. And now let's protect our form and test it and make sure that it works like we want it to. So we're going to come to our developer tab, click on restrict editing, making sure that our number 2 is filled in for filling in forms. We're going to click yes, start enforcing protection. And then we won't put in a password right now. We'll just click OK. So let's go ahead and type in a name and hit tab. And notice that up here at the top, our form field is repeating up here where we've inserted that style ref. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it, hit subscribe to my channel, and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Visit my website at SharonSmithHR.com. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you all next time. Bye-bye.